then, from the cross, the fifth word is spoken. After this, Jesus, knowing that all things were now accomplished, and that the scripture might be fulfilled, he said, "I thirst." Now there was a vessel full of vinegar. They filled a sponge with the vinegar, put it on hyssop, and then put it to his mouth. "I thirst." Christ echoes every human being's experience of bodily needs, our hungers, our thirsts, as he descends into the fullness of his human nature, leaving divinity behind. He absorbs every part of our humanity, every appetite, every need. He's totally connected to a body that's suffering, feeling the suffering even more than any one of us could imagine. It's not just his thirst that's happening. And that word in the scripture, ancient word, comes from Old Testament, meaning not only a bodily thirst, but a thirst for so much more. In that word, Jesus is not only telling us, you and me, that his full humanity is now filled with the agony of hanging on this cross, that everything that's human that causes pain is now his, including the fact that he's thirsty. How often in my gospel ministry did we find it important to be in a room when someone was really, really suffering, to make sure that they had some kind of a swab to wet their lips and their mouth? It's a comfort, but it's something that we need in those moments of a bodily closing, a body that's giving everything away, a body that will no longer be functioning. I thirst. But the thirst, my dear brothers and sisters, in that Hebrew word means it's bigger than this body. That he thirsts for us. He thirsts for our love. He thirsts for our connection. He thirsts for our spiritual development and growth. He thirsts for us to be home. He thirsts for us to be with his Father. He thirsts for us never to be out of the triune love. He thirsts for you and for me. I know what that means. In many moments of my life in prayer, I've said no. Yes, I'll admit it. I've said no to Jesus. I don't want to do this. I don't want this as part of my ministry. Recently, that was over the last few years with my sister, and afterwards in a deep grief. And I really cut the Lord out of me, out of my prayer, out of studying scripture. I wanted to be alone by myself. And that's what I chose. And then one day before the Blessed Sacrament, as only Jesus could, as he always will if we're willing to listen, he understands us and knows our pain. And a song came into my head. And all of a sudden the song took on a life of its own, and it was Jesus singing to me. And I broke down in tears in the chapel. I'm going to try to sing that as the end of this reflection. I know Jesus thirsts for me. I just don't always want to quench his thirst. He thirsts for all of you as well. These two words are saying, I need all of you to change the world. I need all of you to love as I have loved. And so this was a song, and it's not by him. Sometimes Jesus uses very contemporary music in my prayer at times. Because I wished you the best of. Heartbreak and misery.
It's hard for me to say, I'm jealous of the way you're happy without me. 'Cause I wish you the best of all this world could give. And then I told you when you left me, there's nothing to forgive.